Hi guys, this is Bolade again, and right now I'm about to talk to a friend, a very good friend of mine. I've been knowing him for a very long time. The funny thing about this is that, you know, his story actually inspired me to start this now. It's kind of twisted, but it's also inspiring. Please, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Dewunmi, the creator of E.X.O.
How you guys doing?
Great. Dewunmi, nice to see you again, man.
You're looking
You're looking good always, man.
I'm trying.
I like the shirt.
Thank you. Yeah, especially made for the book, so hopefully you'll be able to grab this once it gets out.
The book. So EXO is a book? Like, how is it, like a like this big?
Yeah, no, this is not encyclopedia, but I mean, funny story, EXO actually was supposed to be an animated series. I mean, I'm still pursuing that. So what happened was I put together some money to get the series started, and I created like a 10-minute test, actually 8 minutes of animation that I used to test out, and I sent it to distributors, investors, and a lot of people liked it. They were like, wow, this is great, excellent. But they didn't want to put money down because I'm creating a superhero based on a character from Nigeria, Africa.
Superhero from Nigeria?
Yes.
Okay. What? Why?
I mean, it's for me personally. So I grew up in Nigeria, obviously, and I grew up watching Batman, Superman, Iron Man, Ninja Turtles, Transformers. Like, yeah. I was all about that. But as the years passed, I realized that we didn't have representation from Nigeria and Africa.
True.
Like, we're our own superheroes. Like,
true.
We're our own characters.
True.
There was nothing at all. You know, and it had always been a dream of mine to do something like that. But you know how life gets at you. Oh, okay, go to school, study computer science, mm-hmm. get a 9-to-5, go to your job, you know, get a house and all this. So all these things, I focused my life around that, but I ignored my dream. And then it got to a point where I felt like, you know what, it's time for me to actually see if I can pursue this, because I've always had a passion for animation, superheroes and everything. And interestingly enough, when I got to the United States, that was when the whole superhero thing started blowing up, like the Batman movies that came out, Iron Man and all these things. So I decided, look, now is the time for Africa and Nigeria to be represented when it comes to superhero characters. And that's how the idea for EXO started.
Okay. So EXO means what?
So EXO means endogenic exoskeletal ordnance. Now,
exactly.
I know, I saw your face.
I was like, okay. just EXO, I'll stay with EXO.
Yeah, so just we'll call it EXO for now. When you get the book, it'll actually make a lot more sense in there. Yeah, so everything is tied around the name of the EXO itself. So the whole story is tied around that, because EXO is actually the suit that powers our hero, Wally Williams.
You know, speaking of Wally Williams, how did you get that name, Wally Williams?
Like, honestly, like, for me personally, what I did is that I just started putting together random names, and I always wanted something that had like the first letter and the last letter. I wanted it to be the same. So if it was AA, WW, whatever it was, and I was brainstorming, I was thinking about names, and funny enough, I have a friend that's named Wally. So I started listening to all my friends. Although I didn't put your own name.
I was just about to ask. So I just want to ask, wait, so how did you skip my name? Like, you don't remember my name?
Okay. Because you don't check up on me.
Oh, wow.
You. But anyway, that's another story. But yeah, I started listening out. So I got to Wally, and I was like, that sounds nice. So I was like, okay, what can I put at the end? And then one of my good friends from Nigeria, his name is Olamide, but his last name is Harrison. So I had Wally Harrison, but I was like, okay, that sounds nice, but you know what, you know, I still want that W. But then I started looking at different things. Then I started writing names of not just my friends, but people like my uncles, my aunties and everything. And I had an auntie, her name is Sherry Williams. So I took her last name and I took my friend's first name and I put that together. And then I had Wally Williams, and the way it just sounded was just perfect to me. And that's how it came about. This is the first time I've actually said that outside. So this is exclusive.
This is exclusive. So you guys hear that?
I don't even know. When we get together, I just start to ramble.
Which is fine. You know, the funny thing is that, you know, the BSuper experience, the interviews that Bolade Ojo show, it's all about positivity, and we look for people that have unique stories, like yourself, that have some intriguing or inspiring story. If I was going to ask you, what actually triggered you? You know, you did mention that, you know, you decided, but something must have just triggered it.
Definitely.
You know, but speaking about BSuper experience, you know, we try as much as possible to find people that have stories or that do stuff in the, you know, that somebody else can listen to and be like, you know what, I think it's time for me to do my to do this. You know.
Yeah.
So speaking of that, what triggered it? What, I mean, you did mention that, you know, the the superhero age kind of came into the movies, but something must have like started ignition.
Yeah, there are a couple of things. The first and the most important thing for me personally, I believe everybody has something inside them, like a dream, a drive that, okay, I was born to do this. I was born to chase this experience, or, you know, I was born to, you know, add this value to either someone else's life or do something patriotic. Whatever it is, everybody has something inside of them that they feel like this is what I was meant to do. And ever since I was a kid, I knew that whatever happened, at the end of the day, I wanted to be doing things when it comes to superheroes, animation, and, you know, pop culture and all that. So that was the first thing, is that it was just me chasing my dream. I'm somebody that I'm a proponent of, if you have something that you care deeply about, there's a reason why you care deeply about
it. So when did you start? When did you kick it off?
I kicked this off March 2012. This is 3 years ago.
Wow. So yeah. 2012 is about what? 3 years ago?
Yes, 3 years ago is when I started. But I always had the dream. Like, I had it since I was a kid. It wasn't until...
So it's important to have a dream.
I wouldn't say, like, I mean, we're all different. You know, I wouldn't say it's important. I believe a dream is not something that you force. It's something that you're born with. It's inside you. I believe everyone has it. That's what I'm saying. I'm not saying it's important to have it. I personally believe that everybody has something inside them that they want to.
So in March 2012, what started
it? Yeah. So what started was, for me personally, I feel like when it comes to Africa, Nigeria, and other countries in Africa, there's a way that we are portrayed in the media that it's not always positive. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. A lot of times when you see Africa on, you know, TV or news or whatever, it's not all the time, but most of the time it's negative. And for me, I wanted to do what I could do to change the stereotype, to change the way people see Africa. You understand what I'm saying? Matter of fact, I'll tell you another story about, you know, what happened when I started promoting the book. But for me personally, I wanted to use this book as a way to, you know, show that Africa does have talent. Everybody that worked on the book is, they're Nigerians, all Nigerians. Like, now I'm here in the US. I have a lot of friends that are artists. I could have hired them here. It's actually easier for me to work
that are
with people
not Nigerians,
here.
Right?
Yeah. No, it's not that it's easier for me to work with people that are not Nigerians. It's easier for me to work with people that are within
the US.
Within the US. It's much easier. But I made it a very, very, very important goal that, look, I wanted people in Nigeria to work on this book, because they are the ones that they are seeing how everything is going on in Nigeria. So I wanted to showcase, because at the end of the day, I believe if you put my book out there, and if you put a book from, let's say, you know, Marvel, you know, Spider-Man or DC Comics, Superman, and you put mine in the middle, you won't be able to say, okay, this is the one from Africa they tried. It's almost like, yes, it's world class. And that's what I want to prove. I want to prove that Africa does have the talent to put things, like when it comes to animation, comic books, you know, superhero stories, it can be represented on a global level.
And how many people do you have on your team in Nigeria?
In Nigeria, there are three of them. So there's my editor is Ayodele Elegba, then the artist himself, Sukomi Akinboye, and then the colorist is Raphael Kazim. That's my main team.
And then do you what?
I'm the creative director, the creator, and the writer.
Okay, yeah, so you write the story.
Yeah, I write the story, and then I also give guidance in terms of, okay, this is how I want it to look.
Do you also write the conversation?
Yeah, the dialogue, everything. Yeah, everything, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So you mentioned something earlier about the animation series.
Yes.
That was the initial thought.
And
is that, are we still going to have?
Oh yeah, definitely,
series?
Definitely. Sometime in the future, there's actually an animation test that I put on YouTube.
And I did see that. Oh my God.
Yeah. So you can see, you know, see where I'm going.
Very
with
good.
It. Yeah. Exactly. Very I good. Don't like, for me personally, like, I get very upset when if someone from Nigeria or someone from Africa does something and they put it out there, oh yeah, they tried, oh, Africa is trying. I hate it when I hear that. Do you understand what I'm saying?
So it's true.
Yeah, I want to get to a point where people see stuff from Africa and it's like, it's good, it's world class. Not, oh yeah, for African standards, it's great. Do you understand what I'm saying? So that's right. I'm trying to change that perception. So in terms of the animation, because of how much it costs, what I'm trying to do now is with the book, I'm funding the book myself. I can't fund the animation myself because of the level I want to do it at. I'm funding the book myself, and once I put it out there, I'm hoping that I can build a large enough fan base that I can go back to distributors and investors and say, look, the book is out. So and so amount of people are already following the book. If we create the animation, it's going to make money because we already have a fan base. Okay. Do you understand? It's easy for someone like, all right, if like for instance, if you want to do a Spider-Man cartoon now, you don't have to prove to an investor, okay, people are going to watch Spider-Man because there are already so many Spider-Man fans from the comics they've read. So that's kind of like the route I'm trying to take now.
Sure. We're going to watch a quick clip of your animation, one on YouTube. So you guys, you can just watch this animation quickly. I'm sure you're going to love it. And you know, when the book comes out, I'm sure you're gonna love it too.
Yes, definitely.
I wasn't born a hero. I had to become one. To protect my people. And put an end to the schemes that oppress them. That was my father's last wish. Some ask if I am truly what the people need. Others say I will inevitably bring this city to its demise. Not on my watch.
Hi guys, welcome back, and I'm sure you've seen the animated series for EXO. Amazing, amazing. When I saw it, I was blown away. Very nice animated series, and I'm sure you know, with what Dewunmi has in plan, he's trying to get the book out to get to the goal of having this animated series. Just imagine you have this animated series, just like how you have Superman, Batman, and all that stuff. You have EXO.
Yes, sir.
You know. Crazy. The only thing I'm not happy about is that he didn't use my name. You know, Bolade, Ola-Ojo, Superman with a cape. You know, and that square chin. But anyways, I'm joking. But anyways, one thing I really want him to touch on is, you know, because I want someone out there to see this interview and say, you know what, I'm inspired. His story, his work has inspired me to decide and just commit to my goal, to my dream. So I want him to talk about that. You know. What message do you want someone out there watching this to say, okay, I want to take this on?
I mean, for me personally, I think I also mentioned it earlier. I believe strongly in when you have a passion for something, you know, make a plan and try and go for it. So I'm not going to sit down here and, you know, pretend like I'm not running a business and I don't want to make money, because obviously that's how I live my life. I want to use what I've created so far as an avenue for me to tell my stories, my personal stories. So EXO is just the first of many stories that I have to tell, but I need to do everything possible to make this one successful first. Because one of the things that I see people doing usually that I kind of feel like may not be the best way. Everybody that has been successful, not just in, you know, books, animation, or whatever, you can always tie back to one thing.
Right.
Look at Disney. It was Mickey Mouse first. If you look at Google, it was a search engine first.
Right.
If you look at, you know, Apple, it was the Mac computer
right.
first. So this is my flagship, and like this character.
Boom.
Yes, exactly. So for me, what I want people to get, you know, if you move around the business side of it, I want people to be inspired. I want people to look at me and say, look, if this guy can do it, why can't I do it too? Because For me, look, I work hard, but there's nothing, I wouldn't say there's nothing special about me, but there's nothing that I'm doing that is magical. Like, it's just hard work, dedication, persistence, and just having a passion for something. And I'm being willing to go out for it and actually work hard to get it, because it's not going to be easy.
How is the funding for this? Because I speaking about
right
easy, I know mm-hmm. it must be expensive to get this out there.
So the funding, like I said, for the book itself, the animation I'll talk about later, the book, the funding is coming all from me.
Wow.
Right, so for
this
the product, I had to beg my family too. Coming to that, also there was the kicks. I ran a Kickstarter campaign that kind of supplemented things, you know. So for that one, I was trying to raise about $3,500 because I already paid for everything, like the production of the book, you know, paying the artists and everything. But I needed money to print the book, actually print. So I wanted to, you know, let me get $3,500, print about maybe 200 books when it comes out, and then when I make money back from that, I'll go back to print or whatever. But we ended up raising $10,000.
Wow.
You know, so now I can print more books, I can have a larger distribution and everything. So
man, yeah, which pay me for not using my name.
Right. And you know, so I mean, the Kickstarter wasn't only about funding. Like, for me personally, it was more of a revelation that this is the right thing that you're doing. The fact that a lot of people actually went after
it. Trust me, when I saw the thing and I got the message about a Kickstarter and I got the link to go watch the YouTube stuff,
mm-hmm.
it didn't take me a second to think. I was like, I didn't even think about it. I was like, if he can do this,
right,
definitely, I need to support this guy. Boom.
Right.
You know, apart
right.
from the fact that you're my friend and, you know, we friends support each other,
yes.
kind of things like this. But then, like you said, the quality, you've seen it. And if you haven't seen the animated series or if you haven't seen the work and stuff he puts out there, you definitely need to see it. When you see it, you'll be like, where is this guy? I need to meet this guy. I need to give him a handshake at least. It's amazing. Now, who is Dewunmi? You know, people. A lot of people know you as the animation guy. Mm. I know you because you and I have worked on some few projects from a couple of the artists that right. we manage at BSuper Entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
But then, who is Roy? Who is Dewunmi? What's your last name again?
Okukpe.
Yeah.
That's a very interesting
question. Do not say it's a tough question, because
it's not tough now.
Okay.
You know that, like, it's hard, like, okay, trying to... Okay, let me say this.
You can blow your ego, it's fine. You can say Dewunmi is the chairman, the
kind of
big
person.
Boy chairman.
I let my work speak for myself.
Oh, here we go.
And I leave it there. But yeah, it's funny you mention that, because I know you've called me Roy now, you've called me Dewunmi. So
right.
Roy is my nickname.
Right.
Dewunmi is my name that my father gave me.
As Roy.
Yes, I know. And so I just want to, a lot of people use interchange, which is fine. And I answer to anyone. You can write checks to both of them, Roy and Dewunmi.
Oh, for real?
Cash it, yes.
Wow.
But that's beside the point. Dewunmi is a guy that tries to live by five things. Persistence, perseverance, passion, humility, and hard work. Honestly, in the last 3 years, that's how I've lived my life.
This guy should be a pastor.
No.
No. I feel like I should be in his congregation. Preaching pastor.
I've not read that level yet. But no, on a more serious note, I realized when I first decided that I wanted to start, you know, doing this thing, like EXO, the superhero story, the book, the animation, I had to live by those five things, because that's what has gotten me from where I was 3 years ago to where I am right now. You know, like I said earlier, well, I didn't say that earlier, but you know, those things have made me, they've given me the opportunity to appear on CNN, BBC, Forbes, Huffington Post, you
right.
know, and some other, you know, big, you know, blogs and websites right. that in my wildest imaginations, I wouldn't have thoughts that I'll be there right now.
Funny thing is, you mentioned CNN. I actually saw the
article.
Yeah, right. So yeah. The article. I was like, wow, shoot, this guy's on CNN. Tell me about that quickly. Just tell us about that.
That probably was the most
biggest hallmark.
The biggest thing that has happened to me so far, and it was a very humbling experience, and I'm very grateful to God that happened, because it's. It's very rewarding when you work so hard for something and then somebody or an organization like that actually recognizes you. And
right.
I didn't pay CNN anything. I didn't have to, you know, kill myself to get on there. Like, I just kept on working out, putting my stuff out there.
And they
were able to see what I was doing. And it's not just about me. It's also the people that are, like, people supporting on Kickstarter, people sharing it on social media, people like you promoting it or interviewing me. Right. Like, what people don't know is that the more you do that, every time you click like or you click share or you send it to someone, it actually goes a long way. Because what happens is that someone else sees it and sends it to someone else, who sends it to someone else, who knows someone somewhere else. And that's the way things happen.
Connection happens.
Yeah.
Very key, very key. And BBC was also
a BBC article. Came after CNN. So once I appeared on CNN, so it was just like a
back to back
domino thing. After I got on CNN, a lot of people started contacting me for interviews and everything. So it's been very humbling. It's been very great. But this is just the beginning. I'm nowhere close to where I feel this needs to be or where I want to go. So it's pretty exciting.
So is Dewunmi single, married, or divorced? I mean,
that last part. I'm single.
Single?
I'm very single.
Ladies. Oh my God. So single, searching or work, too much work, you can't search.
I always personally feel like the best things come when you're looking for them. So I wouldn't say I'm searching, but I wouldn't also say I'm not searching. So for me,
you're a politician, man. Look at this guy.
So he's, I told you before I started.
I like that. I'm going to start using that line. Okay. And your family, if you don't mind me asking, are they here or back home?
They're all over the place. So, I mean, my mom is here right now. She's
proud.
She's proud beyond anything, and she's even helping me promote it too. Like, she's all over the place.
I can imagine your mom, talking about EXO.
All of our friends that are 50 and above, giving them, showing them. And everybody, like, that's what people don't get. A lot of people are actually behind the scenes, not just young people, it's old people too, because they see the value in being Africa, Nigeria being represented on a global level. Mm-hmm. So, whatever it is that you're doing, like, as long as you have passion for it and you can show that passion, I believe people will always jump on your back and try and push you.
And question, so before you started, did you?
Yes.
I'm guessing you did some research. Is there anybody out there also doing the same? Like from Nigeria or Africa or something like that?
Yeah, there are people that are doing it too. Like, especially now more and more that, you know, the whole superhero thing is exploding. Back in 2012, there weren't a lot. There were still people doing that. And that's what people say. Sometimes when the people see my stuff, they come out and say, oh, it's the first African superhero. It's not the first. What I'm trying to do is just...
It's probably the first, but...
Yeah, exactly. Right. And the way I'm doing it, because I'm doing it in a way where I'm not just... As much as I'm doing it for a patriotic reason, yes, I want to make Africans and Nigerians proud. I'm not just doing it for that audience. It's a Nigerian and African story anyone can connect to.
Just like Made in China. Made in China Made in China... No, I'm serious. Made in China makes China look great.
Right.
But it's everywhere.
Everywhere.
This, I bet you.
If you look at the
water, it's probably made in China. Like everywhere, everything is made in China. And that's, you know, and funny thing is, you see the tenacity, the work ethic and tenacity of people, you know, from China. I have Chinese friends.
Yeah.
A lot of them, their work ethic is beyond normal. And, you know, they have, some of the things that you said mm-hmm. are things that they say, you know, they want to make their country proud. They want to represent, you know, apart from the fact that you want to make money, live a good life, mm-hmm. you know, leave a legacy for their kids and all that good stuff. You know, they're very family oriented.
Yes.
But then it's always key that to hear them say, my country or my, you know, Chinese people.
Yeah.
And they have a very tight niche, you know, and it's a great thing to see someone from Nigeria, from Africa doing the same thing. And it is very important. Yes. So I'm going to ask you a couple of random questions, just random questions. So in the morning when you wake up.
Yeah.
First thing you do not tell me you pray. don't even tell
I pray
me.
In the night before I sleep.
Okay, good. He talks to God at night. Okay, so in the morning, what's the first thing you do? First thing
check
you
my phone.
You check your phone.
Yes.
May God deliver you.
I'm trying to be honest, man.
No, you may God. Wow.
I know.
It's we need bad. To get. You know, one time it's I tried bad. this crazy thing. I tried to not use my phone for 2 days.
Yeah,
I
almost went mad. I can't do that.
Nah, neither can I. I almost went crazy.
At least not now.
Not to use my phone for 2 days. It was Yeah,
it's tough. I mean, but I mean, to some extent, you have to balance.
Well, for some, yeah. Well, for someone like you, you know, your phone, you probably have to be in constant contact with.
Yeah, I'm on my phone almost 24 hours.
So, if somebody wants to find, and we're wrapping up the interview now, if someone wants to find, let's start with support. If someone wants to support you, how can they support you?
To find support, anything, just go to uniquestudios.com. I'm going to spell that as Y-O-U-N-E-E-K studios.com. And you can also find me on Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, Facebook at Unique Studios. So if you're looking for more information, if you want to support, just the website is very clear. It has all the details. I'm not going to, like, for me, it was important that I kept everything central. So if you want to support me, go here. If you want to buy, go here. If you need to go here, everything is in one central place. Yeah.
Good. And so that's for both support and if they want to be part of the...
Yes, and if you want to find out more about it, find out when the book is coming out, if you want to buy the book when it comes out, just go to the website.
So when is the book coming out?
The book should be out towards the end of August.
Towards the end of August.
Yes.
And the price point?
It's going to be $14.99.
And sold on all major...
Yeah, it's going to be on my website, Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Nook, Google Play. I'm putting it everywhere. Everywhere. And it's also one thing I always want to clarify is because a lot of people think it's just a comic book. Now, there are two things. There's comic book and there's graphic novel. They're basically the same thing, but a graphic novel is just longer. So a comic book is like maybe 22 pages. A graphic novel is like 100 pages and up. So mine is 130 pages.
Whoa.
Yeah, it's a lot. Yeah, a lot of stuff.
I don't want to get into it. Let's just leave it there.
Episode.
So hobbies, what are your hobbies?
Video games.
I was about to say apart from video games and animations and stuff like that, something unrelated.
Yeah, sports.
Sports.
And then
what sport do you play? Basketball.
Basketball, soccer. Anytime I can see you. So
soccer, no. Basketball, maybe. But soccer, definitely.
Yeah,
definitely,
and also I like whatever.
That's my
level. I love movies.
I'm
all
that
over that.
Okay, and I know you have just to promote your other group. So
yes.
I know you're into some other things. I've seen you act, dance.
Yes.
Sing.
Rap.
Rap. You don't sing. No, you do.
I do. Yeah.
You
kind
dabble
of,
a
yeah.
little,
I'm,
but then
I'm not very
but
good,
more of
but
rap.
Yes, more of rap. Yeah.
More of rap. Okay. Yeah. Wow. Any name of group?
Oh yeah, PC Crew.
PC Crew.
Please check out PCCrew.com. Those are my guys. Gospel hip hop, and the music you'll be blown away. So yeah, I still do that.
You still do that too?
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, definitely.
All of this in 24 hours?
I try to, but you see, the way I do it is that I space it out.
Space it out.
Yeah, so I may take 3 months to do this, two months to do that, blah, blah, blah.
And you see, this is what we're talking about. Somebody out there may be saying, man, I don't have the time to do this. I don't have the time to do that. This is someone that does rap, sing, dance, act. He has an animation series, a book, 130 pages. he's single and he's searching, and that is a lot of work. But you know, the point I'm trying to make is there's no excuse that you don't have time. You just have to get it done. Just get it done. No wasting of time. Now, just to wrap up, there's something we say at BSuper Experience, something that we want to channel to everybody that watches our shows. And we hope that you know we use our episodes and series and interviews that we do to motivate and inspire someone out there about everything. You know, we believe one thing. Not all superheroes wear capes.
Mm.
So I don't. Does EXO wear cape?
He doesn't. He has his suit actually.
Thank you.
So you're spot on that. One.
Not all superheroes wear capes. So
you
and I are superheroes.
You are
a superhero. He is a superhero. Why? Because he has taken the step to do something extraordinary. As you could tell, superheroes, they task themselves. They do exactly what this man does. To achieve something, to there's a goal, there's a dream, there's a work ethic, and that's what a superhero does. So guys, I want to encourage you with Mr. EXO's story today. Be that superhero that does extraordinary stuff. Thank you. Man, thanks man for coming.